Hey, howdy, y'all. Welcome back to Shotgun, and that is it. Alright, so, if you've been following along, I was in this 10-day video challenge, and with KZBFPV. Now, whether or not he's gonna acknowledge it or not, it's a different story, but technically, we both failed. It's been 12 days since we put up the first video. He still hasn't put up day 10. I technically did have day 9 and 10 up on the 10th day, but one was a live stream where I just shotgun beers and bullshitted with basically Tack and KZB and maybe some other people. I don't know. I was hammered and it got a little embarrassing, and I talked a bunch of shit about things. And so I took him down of fear of having to deal with the all seeing eye that I deal with. Yeah, and then day 10 was me sitting out back by a fire, hammered drunk. So I took him down. You'll never see him unless you saw it. Then you saw it and that's it, but they're gone now. Anywho. That's my point. So, today is, I did what I wanted to do for day 10. Sam, I told you to be quiet, please. I put the Caddx Turtle V2 in my floss. So, I have hopefully a super duper light quad. That will give me halfway decent HD footage. If you go back and watch day 8, that's where I talk all about it. But I also want to showcase a little technique that I certainly did not come up with. As far as I know, well, either phased FPV or adapt FPV came up with it, or maybe they got it from somebody, but I don't know. It's brilliant. Sam, come on now. I'm trying to film something here. This is Shotgun Junior. He's the greatest thing in my life, other than FPV and my wife. But he's a 3-year-old, and he can be a handful at times, especially when I'm trying to film stuff. But gosh dang it all the heck, he's cute, so we let him slide. But anywho, that's what I'm talking about right there. Focus. Maybe I'm just too close. Yeah. The foam. It's ugly, but it's extremely effective. Well, I mean, I've actually never done it before, so, but I can only assume it's extremely effective. Phase is like, phase and adapt are the fastest guys around here. And Christian just took 7th in the world at the MotoGP Championships. Whether or not he was using this foam, I don't know, but Phase definitely does all the time. And what is good about it is that it protects your camera and whatnot. I thought it was silly when I first saw it, but if you look, you fly like this, and then when you hit the foam, and you would have to hit awfully damn hard. And with this floss, it's so light, it would never happen. But I mean, if you hit perfectly like that, you might still be able to get at the camera. But most likely, you're gonna be like that. And I probably could have done the foam better. It's the first time I've done it, so cut me some slack. But it's ugly, but incredibly effective. So, and it's not like, it looks like styrofoam, but it's not. It's, I'll have to put the name of it in the description, because I can't remember what Fredericks called it. Fredericks, thanks, buddy, again, gave me this big old piece of it, and this will last me forever. Cause like that little chunk right there is only half of what I actually use. The other half is right there, but it was a little chopped up in that area, and so I decided to start with the crappy part first. Samuel Lee, knock it off! But it's like, it's super durable foam, and I can't remember what the hell he called it. You can't just like snap it or break it like you can with styrofoam. You have to, I don't have a super sharp knife big enough, but it cuts, an X-Acto blade cuts it like butter, and basically what I did was just get it started with an X-Acto blade and then kind of delicately worked at it with one of my kitchen knives. And then you just zip tie the bad thing on there. And then I took the advantage of having something extra to mount something to and just zip tied my antenna to it. But anywho, yeah, I just kind of crammed the Turtle V2 in there. I didn't even have to, I thought I was going to have to like splice wires and stuff like that, but I don't know about y'all, but when I swap cameras, even if the connectors aren't the same, I'll just take that little 3-pin connector and just shove it in half of the 5-pin connector and call it a day. That's how I've always done it. As long as the power, ground, and video are in the right spots, good enough for me. And that's all I did. Plugged it in with the smoke stopper, obviously. And everything powered up and seemed to be functioning perfectly fine. So let's cut to some floss ripping with the Turtle V2. I have the ND filter, the ND8 filter for the Turtle V2. We're going to do a run with out the ND filter and then one with the ND filter. But unfortunately, every damn time I go to try and test this Turtle V2 and how well the ND filter works, it's always a stupid, overcast, gloomy day. So it's at least three times now I've tried to test the... how well the ND filter actually works for that turtle. And all 3 days, it's been a stupid overcast day like this. I know, buddy, I said stupid, sorry. We don't say that word. But anywho, enough rambling. Let's get to ripping. Deuces. Say bye.
Bye.
Initial rip actually went better than I thought it was going to. There is surprisingly very little jello right off the bat. I really didn't take it for granted. I don't know why I never thought of it, but there's a whole lot of motors and frame and everything in the view, but yeah. I don't know. The picture quality isn't the greatest, and my FPV feed is the picture quality of that is pretty horrendous. I've been running this quad with the Micro Sparrow 2, which is a pretty quality FPV camera, which gives you a pretty damn good picture. And actually, no. It wasn't even that. It was the Foxier Monster, because I run 6x9. You know, it's funny. I hated this FPV camera at first. The first time I flew it, I was like, oh my God, it's horrible. For some reason, I've come around on it. Either that or my standards have lowered. I don't know. I guess I'm used to it now. But it's a lot better picture quality than the Caddx, that's for sure. But it doesn't give me HD footage. And I can flip the mounts around to get the camera out there more, so I don't get all the motor. I mean, I'll probably still get some props and stuff like that in the shot, but then you're just asking for it to get smashed in one crash. So I'll deal with the motors and stuff. And really, it's just my main objective was to just have HD footage on a super light quad that's really fun to just rip balls, and I got that. So, I would say mission accomplished. And I haven't even run it with the ND filter yet.